the untreated. This is the rinsed. Fully treated.
For performing future experiments, I would like to have a way to make my clothes or other material I'm wearing or have around fireproof. To do that, I found information in the Dangerous Book for Boys that claims to be able to make cloth fireproof. And I believe that what they're saying is correct, but I want to test it on a variety of different cloths. In the Dangerous Book for Boys, they said that any porous cloth could be made fireproof by mixing 500 grams of aluminum potassium sulfate with a pint of water, which is 2 cups. When I tried to mix 250 grams of aluminum potassium sulfate in 1 cup of water, not much of it dissolved. And I have about 3.5 cups of water here, and there's still undissolved aluminum potassium sulfate in the mixture. So that doesn't seem to be very correct. But it could be that they were probably measuring it as hydrated, which it can take 12 water molecules for every molecule of aluminum potassium sulfate, or alum. And the stuff I had may or may not have been hydrated. I assumed it was, because that's how it's most commonly found, and this was not like a scientific supply. But who knows? I'm going to continue putting this cloth in water and seeing what it does. For one set of cloth, I'm going to be wringing it out afterwards. I think how it works is to get the aluminum potassium sulfate in, the aluminum potassium sulfate dries, and so the aluminum potassium sulfate is left in the cloth while the water evaporates. Another set, I'm going to not rinse out, but just let drip dry, and then give it a little rinse in water, because they thought that getting it a little bit wet wouldn't ruin it. The third, I'm going to just let drip dry and test as is, and I'll have a fourth set of control, which I'll test without the treatment. I have a variety of cloths, some synthetic, some wool, and some cotton. And I want to see, one, which ones burn untreated better or worse, and then which ones, how they react to treatment. For the ones where I'm giving them a little bit of a water treatment, I'm just going to plunk them in, shake them around a little bit, let them drip dry, and then put them on this. Basically to see how well the solution reacts to a little bit of water. I know it's not much, and this is just cold tap water, so it's not even that good for dissolving stuff. But it's a test. I've also put 3 different paper products, some just kind of white paper, some cardboard, and some newspaper, to see how those react to this fireproofing treatment or fire-resistant treatment. And I should note that the untreated stuff is really soft. The fully treated stuff is really hard,
rinsed is really hard, and so is the kind of the squeezed out stuff. So there's an obvious difference between the untreated and the rest of them, but between the other ones, it isn't so big.
Before we get to lighting things on fire, I also noticed the cloth dried out very slowly after it had been treated. I then proceeded to test each of the 14 fabrics for flammability. I applied a propane blowtorch to each of the fabrics. The amount of time that this was applied was not the same or even well controlled, but I think I have an idea about how each of the samples reacted. In general, the untreated fabric burned much easier than the treated material, with the air-dried, unrinsed fabric, what I call fully treated, being the most fireproof. However, the other two types of treatment, the squeezed out and rinsed, performed almost as well. Each different sample performed differently, but in general, the wool did not burn whether treated or untreated. The untreated cotton burned, although the treated cotton would have flames for a second or two after heavy application of the blowtorch, it would quickly go out. The synthetic would melt, the treatment also seemed to reduce this melting, and both treated and untreated would burn, but it was harder to get the treated burning. The paper all burned, though there was an increase in the amount of time it took to light the treated paper. I now realize that using a blowtorch was a stress test, as I am unlikely to have such intense heat and wish I had also tested a sample or two of each type with a smaller flame, particularly the synthetic fabric. I also wish I had given the rinsed fabric more of a rinsing, maybe a night out in the rain. These clips are just a sample of what I filmed while testing. If you would like to see the full-length video, there will be a link in the description and on screen. I feel this experiment shows that aluminum potassium sulfate can greatly reduce the flammability of fabric. When picking clothes to wear around a fire, my first choice would be wool, which does not need to be treated. My second choice would be cotton, whose flammability can be greatly reduced by treating it.